Good morning, all of you. We are starting chapter Water Resources Geography. If you will see water, which is the most important resource for human beings forever, and 3/4 of the earth surface which is covered with water. But if you are talking about fresh water, so only a small proportion of it is fresh water that can be used. And fresh water is mainly obtained from surface runoff and groundwater. Water, which is a renewable resource, but still, nowadays we discuss about water scarcity, isn't it? Always water shortage. So what are the reasons behind it? But before starting this, we will just discuss about some facts about water. 96.5% of the total volume of world's water is estimated as oceans, and only 2.5% as fresh water, and nearly 70% of this fresh water occurs as ice sheets, glaciers in Antarctica, Greenland, and the mountainous regions of the world. And less than 30% is stored as groundwater. तो हम किसकी बात करें, 2.5% का भी 30%. इंडिया रिसीव्स नियरली 4% ऑफ द ग्लोबल प्रेसिपिटेशन. आई थिंक यू विल बी अवेयर व्हाट इज प्रेसिपिटेशन. क्या होता है प्रेसिपिटेशन? रेनफॉल. इंडिया रिसीव्स नियरली 4% ऑफ ग्लोबल, यानी वर्ल्ड का जितना भी रेनफॉल है, 4% India receives data and ranks 133 in the world in terms of water availability per person per annum. And total renewable water resources of India are estimated 1,897 square kilometer per annum. And you can't imagine that by 2025, it is predicted that large part of India will join countries or regions having absolute water scarcity. Now, can you believe it? Even in world also, global level also, it is predicted nearly 2 billion people will live in absolute water scarcity, and India will also among that country. So now, what is water scarcity?
Now water matlab drinking water ki kami.
Yes, when we are talking about water scarcity, that means shortage of water. Bas when we talk about water scarcity, we associate water scarcity with areas where less rainfall or drought area. But do you think that is the only reason? No. Water scarcity is not only about water shortage. That we can say quantitative water scarcity, any less water available. But water scarcity is due to quality of water, that is called qualitative water scarcity. You just see this image, and now it is very common in India because the monsoon season is going on. Water, water, every year, everywhere. not a drop to drink. After a heavy downpour, a boy collects drinking water in Kolkata, life in the city and its adjacent district was paralyzed because of overnight rain, flooded vast area and disruptive traffic also. So is it possible that an area of region may have ample water resources, but is still facing water scarcities? Yes, our cities are such examples. So water scarcity, what are the causes of water scarcity? So first, we will just discuss about the causes. When we are talking about the causes of water scarcity, the most important role played by that is overpopulation. In India, overpopulation is the main cause of water scarcity and overexploitation. Overexploitation by the farmers also. Farmers having their own well and tube well leads to a fall in groundwater level. As we discussed last year also, that is when farmers adopted modern farming methods, the demand for water increased, and this is the reason that farmers' requirement of water increased, and the areas where green revolution occurred facing the problems of water scarcity. Even when we are talking about Punjab, as I told you many times, Punjab, which is made up of two words, Panj plus Ab, that means five river bodies, now considered as drought area. And the credit goes to Green Revolution. And there is a fall in ground level water. And post-independence, after independence, that is industrialization and urbanization, that are responsible for this water scarcity. It causes heavy use of water, multiplying urban centers with large population. As we can easily understand, the population of the country, especially in cities, million plus cities, and urban lifestyle aggravated the problem of water scarcity. The ever-increasing number of industries, apart from being heavy users of water, it also requires power to run, that is hydroelectricity, that also increased. So, industrialization and urbanization are also equally responsible for the water scarcity. Next is not only quantitative but qualitative aspect of the water that is also responsible for the water scarcity. That is, consider about the areas where water is sufficiently available but is still shortage of water, and this is due to bad quality of water. So now there is a growing concern that even if there is ample water to meet the needs of the people, much of it polluted by, that is through domestic and industrial waste, chemical fertilizers, इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट, पेस्टिसाइड्स एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स यूज इन एग्रीकल्चर एंड दैट मेक्स वाटर हैजार्डियस फॉर ह्यूमन लाइफ. सो नाउ I hope that you understood that the need of the hour is to conserve and manage our water resources, because for ourselves, from health hazards to ensure food security, continuation of our livelihoods and productive activities, and also to prevent degradation of our natural ecosystem, our exploitation and mismanagement of water resources will impoverish these resources and cause ecological crises that affect our life. So now, how can we conserve our resources? Water, which is called a renewable resource, but still nowadays we are talking about its conservation. And the conservation, that is not a new phenomenon. That means not only about present, but we have to think about the future also. So how do we conserve and manage? If we go back to the history, archaeological and historical records show that from ancient times, we have been constructing sophisticated hydraulic structures. Even if you have visited any historical monuments, you must have observed that they are having so beautiful water management system. The sophisticated hydraulic structures like dams, built of stone rubble, reservoirs or lakes, canals, etc. But here we will discuss about some traditional or hydraulic structures in ancient India, which are very popular and which tells us about that how ancient India have successfully adopted this method. In the first century BC, Singhanapuram near Allahabad had sophisticated water harvesting system, channeling the flood water of the river Ganga. Even at the time of Chandragupta Maurya, dams, lakes, and irrigation systems were extensively built. Evidences of sophisticated irrigation works we can found in Kalinga, that is in Orissa, Nagarjuna Konda, Andhra Pradesh, Banur, Karnataka, Kolhapur, Maharashtra. And the most famous Bhopal Lake, which is considered one of the largest artificial lakes built in 11th century. And in the 14th century, tank in Hausa, Delhi, was constructed by Iltutmish for supplying water to Siri Fort area.